Hey guys, Kingpin Light here, and we got Olivia Rodrigo, traitor, live from Austin City Limits. I think it's a video that came out like 4 months ago. At least that's what it said on the YouTube channel. It's been a long time since I did Olivia Rodrigo. I haven't seen any new music from her. But I remember when I reacted to her whole album, and I did. I think she only had like one or two music videos, so everything I reacted to was just a lyric video. So I already heard this song. I've actually already reacted to it, but I haven't reacted to the video, or not video, but like her live. I figured I'd give that a shot, see how she is live. And yeah, you know, it's crazy because when I first started doing reactions, I think Olivia was the first one that people started watching. So like my first 100 subscribers were basically Olivia fans, which is crazy because now I'm at like 1800. So I figured let's go back to our channel roots, so to speak, and let's just jump right in. Oh man, this is like super HD. Let me see if I got 4K. No 4K. All right, let's. I'm realizing I probably should have listened to the song before I reacted to this to see so I could pick up like where she's changing things live, because there's artists that like perform live and change it up every time, like they're just free forming it, and then there's artists that are just really really good at keeping even that studio level quality basically to their singing. But I want to point out that it sounded like she did a slight inflection change from what I remember. So, and she's singing really well, so I think maybe she's a mix of the two. She's able to keep studio level quality, like she can actually sing, but maybe she's riffing it a little bit, and of course she's playing an instrument live, which is pretty cool. Brown guilty eyes and little white lies, yeah, I play dumb, but I always knew that you talked to her, maybe did even worse. I kept quiet so I could keep you. And ain't it funny? All right, yeah, those endings are definitely riffed, I think. Because like I said, I haven't actually listened to the song in a little bit, so I don't remember the exact way that it sounded recording wise. But the way she's ending those definitely sound riffed. Not in a bad way. It's just, it's obvious that when it would be recorded, it would be a little bit, it would follow, I think, the beat a little bit differently. And then when she said that sort of, what was it, like the you, and then the funny sounds super, riffed. But again, it's riffed well. It's not like she forgot the song or anything. How you and her, a second that. And ain't it funny how you said you were friends? Now it sure as hell don't look like it. You betrayed me, and I know that you'll never feel sorry for the way I hurt. Yeah, how you talked to her when we were. She's got an amazing live voice, actually, and an amazing mic. I want to see brand that is V21. I know that you'll never feel sorry for the way I hurt. Yeah, how you talked to her when we were together. Loved you at your worst, but that didn't matter. It took you 2 weeks to go off and date her. Guess you didn't cheat, but you're still. I never did my album ranking. Like I was gonna rank the songs, I completely got sidetracked with I moved from California out to the East Coast now, and so with the move, resetting up my studio, everything else, and then just taking off on a couple other different artists, especially I started doing more like worldwide music, it just slipped my mind. So I may have to go back and do that, because I remember Traitor was, I think, in the top four or something like that. I recall that. I did like Driver's License as much, and I know that's like her breakout hit. Right. And I even on the two videos that came out 4 months ago was this one, and it was her performing Driver's License live. And this, I think, has like 4 million views, something like that. And Driver's License had like 10 million views. So even just judging off of those numbers, let alone I've seen a lot of like clips and stuff of her performing Driver's License live on like talk shows and stuff. It's definitely at least commercially her biggest song, right? But I didn't find it as good as a lot of the other songs that were on the album. I think it was a little more. I think the reason I don't like it as much is probably the same reason that it's the biggest. It's I'm not always huge on super mainstream music. It just seems really methodical. Where something like Traitor just sounds so much cleaner, I think.
Shut me down, show her off like she's an empty trophy. I know if you were true, there's no damn way that you could fall in love with somebody that quickly. Ain't it funny? All the twisted games, all the questions you used to avoid. Ain't it funny? Remember I.
I'm not commenting on lyrics because I did that in the original reaction, but I do have two quick notes. I've always wondered this about artists that are like kind of standalone, like singers and rappers. When they have live musicians, like the woman playing guitar, and then there was a woman playing drums, I've always wondered if they're always the people playing it, or if like they just choose based on venue, that sort of thing. I've always wondered that. Like, are they traveling? Do they have what would be the term basically? Are they like known names basically? Or is it just somebody that can play and they'll switch them out when they can, that sort of thing. Also, I just love live. Well, with people that can sing, there's people that just trash live, but I've always liked live performances. Less so on rap, because they usually have like the music playing in the background. It's more so like singers, like Kurt Cobain, actual rock, that sort of thing. Live performances just always have so much more energy, and they're riffed in a certain way where it just feels fresh, even if you've heard the song a million times. We got the littlest girl there wearing the mask. Everyone else is like, ah. I'm not commenting on whether you should or shouldn't. I just find it funny. Yeah, now I remember why I was in my top four. That little portion. And I think I said it on the original reaction. I said that if that little portion was made into a full song, I would have absolutely. I mean, I liked the song already, but I would have absolutely, like, loved it. Man, it is just a whole lot of emotion. Like you can tell she's singing from her heart there, which is cool. I mean, it's not cool because of the content. Like, she had to deal with that. But, like, art and music is just so much better when there's actual emotions behind it.
You're still a traitor.
Damn, she hit that note.
God, I wish that you had thought this through before I went and fell in love with you.
Acapella is dope as hell. In like any genre, just acapella just adds so much umph to it. Ow, that hurt like a Yeah, if you guys probably, especially if you're like some of the people that used to watch my original videos, I'm sure you haven't kept up with every single reaction. So, with different artists, especially like I've done a lot of Cambodian artists. This finger right here, actually, so I broke it completely. Had to get they opened it up for surgery, which is some of the marks that you see there. And then I had to have a pin sticking out of my finger going through the bone and the joint for, I want to say, like a month or two. And I finally got it removed, and I'm supposed to be trying my best to like bend it. But so like this joint here is fine. I can move that one fine. The top joint, you see how it's bent? I can move that one a little bit. Like if I hold the middle part, I can move that a little bit. But then this middle where the pin was, it's so tight. Like that's about as far as I can even bend it. So like when I try and do a fist and I was doing this, that was me trying to practice basically. But yeah, that was really dope. You guys let me know what musical plans she has, because like I said, I haven't kept up with her. I went on her channel to see if she had any new music and I didn't see anything. It was all like releases of music videos of the older songs with some live performances. So I'm curious if she said anything about her coming out with new music. I feel like a year ago or whenever I started reacting to her, there was supposed to be a new album coming out. Like there wasn't released yet, I don't think, but people were just saying like, hey, it's getting close to done, or she finished it or something. And I feel like a year later I haven't seen it. So if you guys know what her plans are, let me know in the comments. And of course, suggest other artists until she drops something, other artists you guys enjoy, and subscribe and like and all that stuff, and I'll catch you guys on the next one.